Good morning, Cougars. Today is Thursday, January 20th, 2022.
Attention juniors and seniors. Barron will be offering three review classes to prepare students to take the SAT and ACT exams on January 22nd, 29th, and February 5th. Information is available on the homepage of the school website and through Canvas.
Attention all boys interested in trying out for lacrosse. Tryouts are Monday and Tuesday, January 24th and 25th. Tryouts will be on the practice field from 4:30 to 6:30 p.m. both days. Please make sure you have all your paperwork submitted to the athletic clearance prior to trying out. See Coach Liba in room 461 for any additional information.
Reminder, there is a student council meeting today at lunch in the auditorium.
Softball tryouts are coming up January 24th from 4:45 to 7:15 p.m. on the softball field. Freshmen wear white, sophomores wear gray, juniors wear blue, seniors wear black.
The girls' soccer team has plenty of opportunities for volunteer hours for both first and second semesters. Imagine having your NH hours done in the second semester in January. Please email Coach Shanks or stop by his room to sign up. Congratulations to the JRTC Cadet of the Quarter, sophomore Caitlin Dawes. Today's athletic events are girls' soccer ball team at Gulf Coast, 5:30 and 7. Boys soccer team versus Gulf Coast, 5:30 and 7. And girls basketball at Gulf Coast, 5:30 and 7. And boys basketball versus Gulf Coast between 4:30 and 7. January 21st, grade level assemblies for freshmen and sophomores period 3 and 4. January 24th, report cards will be published, so make sure you have good grades. All right, that's a wrap for BCTV. I'm your host, Ivory Innes, and for the blue and gray, go Cougars!
Is there any advice that you would give to the girls as they continue to play this season?
Oh, definitely. I'm always encouraging the girls on the team to just keep pushing their hardest to be their best.
How did you become the assistant coach with Coach Shanks?
I coached at Naples before because there was no opening here. And I really wanted to be at Barron because this is where I went to high school and this is where I was when girls soccer started here. So when my kids came to Barron, I was here with my daughter and before school started doing the tour because we missed it when they had it since we were out of town. So we actually got to meet Coach Shanks and that's when I threw my hat in the ring. I just put it out there that I played soccer all my life. I played here when I went here. I played at UCF in Division I and have been coaching most of my life, all different ages, and that if they needed a coach, I was available and was interested.
How long have you guys played soccer together?
We've played together for 12 years now.
What is your way of motivation in a game or at practice?
I like to get better every year, so I try and beat my stats from like my freshman year and my sophomore year and my junior year and just continue to get better.
Okay. Well, it's like my senior year, so I kind of want to end like on a really good, you know, term since I'm not going to be playing ever again.
Good, bud. My motivation is I'm really competitive and I want to. They entrusted me as I look down at my diamond and crushed the piece. Thinking no one man should have all that power. The clock's ticking, I just count the hours. Stop tripping, I'm tripping off the powder. Peel in that the world's ours.
Austin Powers, lost in translation with a whole f***ing nation. They say I was the Obama nation of Obama's nation. Well, that's a pretty bad way to start the conversation. At the end of the day, God, now I'm killing this. I know damn well y'all feeling.
before coaching, what other things that did you do that were related to soccer?
So before I coached soccer, which goes way back, I actually played. I've been playing since I was, before I was in school, because I had an older brother who played soccer. So I was always kicking the ball around with him and at his games and watching his games. And I played soccer all my life, all through high school, all through college. I refereed. I got certified as a referee while I was in college and reffed tournaments all around Orlando. When I came back to Naples after graduating from UCF, I got involved with reffing and coaching in Naples for like the YMCA Little League and reffing high school, middle school soccer, and reffing the YMCA and the other league in town. I can't remember what it is, but before I coached, I reffed, I played, and I love the game. And to really make it their goal to be better today than they were yesterday, to be better tomorrow than they were today, and to just really get clear on what it is they want out of the game and always put their heart and hard work into everything they do in every aspect.
Number 11, Brooke Miller. Diana Galvez. Leah Prostino. Next is number 18, Lola Shea. Number 24, Lisa Tankin.
And blood, I do anything for love and everything for us. Doing everything like everything ain't been too much. You know my favorite time to come through for you is the clutch. Last second, what a rush. Look, I'm the type to talk to the stars. Straight up, these ain't tattoos, these are scars. My young dogs will tear you when the witness is apart.
I've been playing soccer for 8 years. I started in first grade and all my friends played, and that's why I played. And my teammates motivate me to play every single day. And my biggest supporters are my parents and my teammates and my coaches.
Hi, my name is Lena. I'm number 22 on Barron's girls varsity soccer team. I started playing soccer in the third grade and played up until eighth grade. Took a 2-year break and then picked it up again in my junior and senior year of high school. My dad got me into playing soccer as a way to get me outside more and make more friends. And one goal that I had for this season was to make Barron's girls varsity soccer team, despite having never tried out in the past 3 previous years, my freshman, sophomore, junior year. So it was a great accomplishment to make it my senior year as a new member of the team and having never tried out before.
Tell young girl athletes who want to play soccer in high school?
I would say that, like, even if you're not good, to just come out and play, and no matter if you're on JV or varsity, it's a lot of fun, and it's a good way to make friends, so just keep playing.
Yeah, I'd say never give up. I mean, you just kind of have to put the extra time in, effort, and just really work hard to your
I would say that it has, like, a lot of ups and downs, and it's, like, hard sometimes, but staying with it is really, like, I don't know, it's worth it.